My name is Kendare Blake. I am the author of the 3 Dark Crown series. This is book 2, One Dark Crown. If anybody happen to have a copy of book 1, may I borrow that for a second? Thank you so much. It makes it easier to have a visual when I explain it. So 3 Dark Crowns is set on a secluded island. It's surrounded by a protective mist, so it's basically secret from the rest of the world. And on this island, you can have a number of magical gifts. So you can be a naturalist. So you can make things grow. You can, like, talk to fish. I don't know how useful that is. But you could. You can talk to them if you want to. Aquaman makes it look pretty good. So anyway, the most important thing, though, is making things grow. And you have a little animal companion who kind of knows what you're thinking and knows what you're feeling. You can be an elemental to control earth, air, fire, water. Usually not all of them at once, but maybe one or two if you're lucky. You can be, not this, I'm going to go back. You can be an oracle, so you can kind of read people's minds sometimes, or you can see the future a little bit, but that's very rare. And that will be the rarity of it will be explained in a future novella. Or you can be war gifted. So war gifted people are extremely good fighters, and they can actually guide weaponry with their minds. So like, the bows and arrows are crazy accurate. You don't even have to talk to people like, boom, go over there, and there you go. So very convenient to have in a fight. Or you can be a poisoner. So the poisoners are immune to all toxins, and they're expert assassins. They're very good at crafting new poisons to kill people in fun and imaginative ways. So on this island, it's always ruled by a queen. And in every generation, when it's time for the queen to be done ruling, she conceives a set of triplet girls and gives birth to a set of new queens. Always triplets. Always on the same day. It's weird. Like, she's sacred and magical, okay? That's the whole thing. Sometimes she gives birth to 4. We'll get into that later. And when these girls turn 16, their instinct is, and tradition calls for them to murder the crap out of each other until only one remains, and whoever is the last one standing after a year gets to take over and become the new queen. In this generation, we have a naturalist, an elemental, and a poisoner, and 3 Dark Crowns is the story of how this particular generation of girls deals with being put into this traditional situation. So I got the idea from a ball of bees. I don't know, is anybody a beekeeper? It's rare, but sometimes I get one. So before a queen bee will leave her hive, she will lay 4 or 5 queen eggs, and those queen babies hatch out, murder the crap out of each other, and then whichever one of them survives gets to take over the old hive. I learned about this because there was a bee ball between me and a hot dog truck that I really wanted to get to, and I was afraid, but a beekeeper who just happened to be there like Batman, when you need them, they are there, told me not to worry, because if you see a ball of bees, their queen is in the center, and they're only protecting her, that's all they're thinking about, so you can actually like go fairly close to the bee. But anyway, so I found that out about the queen bees, and I was like, magical. That sounds like a lovely thing to do when you just hatch out into the world, and I wanted to do it to people. And so when I was driving home from that book event, after I'd had like 5 hot dogs, I started writing 3 Dark Crowns. Does anybody have any questions right off the bat?
I was cruising on Dreading Book Reads yesterday. And the Queen's
That is the paperback bind-up of the 2 novellas. So there are 2 tie-in novellas with this series. 4 novels and then these kind of novels. So the first one is called the ebook right now. It's called The Young Queens. It tells the story of these 3 queens when they're kids, essentially, from like their birth until when they grow up. I would never don't read that one before you read the first book, but after that, you're pretty much good to go. There are some spoilers in the prequel. And then the second novella is going to be called The Oracle Queen, and it's about a queen from the past who had the sight gift. And murdered like 3 houses full of people without cause, and ended up locked in the tower for the rest of her reign until she had her triplets, and then they're like, good, get out. And that is why whenever a new baby queen is born with the oracle gift, they just drown them. So a little bit of feminine history for you. Yeah, and then queens of feminine. And then the next book will come out in September. If it finishes.
Yeah. You said it's a four book?
It's a four book series. It was originally conceived as a duo, so like, I think these two form a pretty decent arc together, and then the next two form a pretty decent arc together. So, you know, if you're inclined, you can still go for this one. And you'll still have like a, you know, a whole story. Anybody have any other questions or anything they want to talk about? Sometimes we talk about what we would do if we were confronted with a horse-sized duck or 100 duck-sized horses, which way we would go. So it's just a thought.
Two questions. Do you start picturing them as like actual bees?
No. I should. In little dresses?
Did I read like that? I don't know why. That's a whole other story. When you write, do you write all in one thing or do you like go back and forth?
No, I write all in one. I'm just like, yeah, there it is. This is what happened. And then I'm like, I get to the end and I'm like, it's glorious. And then about 2 months later, I'm like, it's shitty. And I go back and I rewrite the whole thing. At least that's how it has been with these books. I rewrote this book, I'm not kidding, 3.5 times. From top to tail. I only rewrote this one twice, and I'm on track to rewrite the third one only 3/4 times. I'm like keeping a quarter of it and then just redoing the rest. So if this holds true, I might be able to do it with rewriting the fourth one in like half a time. Save me a lot. But I don't think that's it. Endings are fun. Fourth book. Any series of this is not looking forward to that. Get to start as soon as I finish my 3.
I know, I'm like, this is a very new format for us. We're all like skittish.
Yeah, at least it's not a bike horn. I've been at once where they're like,
oh no.
I'm like, oh my god.
I like the intimacy of it. It's pretty cool.
It is. Yeah. Well, and you never know what the trail is going to take of the conversation after you get out of the initial book. I actually had a conversation with people about if giraffes could be ridden into battle, what would their armor look like? I mean, obviously there'd be a lot of neck plate.
Now I want to get into that conversation again.
Love that.
Drafts in battle.
Three dark drafts.
Like the next one. Yeah. Oh, lots of tears.
Oh yeah. It'd be too easy to take a giraffe out, though. You just break the legs.
Well, I mean, does with fighting is they lead with the neck. So they're like,
oh, they're smart.
Sweeping you with the neck because they've got all the armor on the neck. And just think if you like studded it with the neck.
Oh my god, that's amazing.
Completely just neck spikes.
Woo!
Hang out like a mace.
Right?
The reverse stegosaurus.
Yeah. How's the... Three Dark Crowns was optioned for film by Fox and one of the producers from Stranger Things. I'm excited about that because I love that show. It's going like a major studio's involved, so they're just now out of contract negotiations. Like that, it optioned last February, and I'm like sending contracts now. So it's taking a while just to get everything going. But at the same time, they can also make things move really fast because they are a big studio and they're already involved. So I don't know. I won't be involved in anything. I've talked to the producers. They actually have female executives running it, which is nice. Like, you hear all the time that there aren't enough female executives in Hollywood, and I totally agree, but I've been lucky enough with every one of my projects that have been optioned with female executives. So it's like I'm living in a nice bubble.
Great note to end on.
Yeah.
Thank you.